So I'm microphoning for ESCcast.com live at the Riga pre-party. Finally, I get to speak to Miklas after we shared a drink last night.
We did. Yes, we did.
You know, it's your first time in Latvia. How's it been for you so far?
It has been very quick. I have arrived yesterday morning. Didn't really see much of the city, only from the car. But we are about to do some sightseeing. Hopefully tomorrow. Yeah. I know that I skipped the today sightseeing because I was feeling a little bit sick. Yeah. But so far, it's been amazing. It's been much bigger than I thought. Yeah. This press conference is quite nice, I would say. I haven't been to a press conference like this before, so yeah.
I think the sightseeing tomorrow is actually going to be slightly nicer because we're going to Jurmala, which is like a seaside town. It's really pretty there. It's really quite nice. Okay. So yeah, walking around the city is okay, but this is more fun, I think.
Okay, right. So I'm excited for that. Cool.
So on to the important stuff. Yeah. We want to hear some secrets about. We know you've got all the dance moves going on. What's going to be happening on the stage in Lisbon?
Maybe some of them too. Okay, right. Definitely some of them. We all agreed that we really liked the video and that it works with the track, and we would like to do something similar to the video.
So does that mean the camel is coming?
No, it's actually animals are not allowed on stage, so no. With combination with all of this, I definitely want to reach out to the people. I think this is a song for the people, as I experienced in Ukraine, where the reaction was really, really crazy. So I would like to do some things that I normally, as an artist, in my concert would do. So yeah, we'll see.
So you filmed your postcard recently as well. That looked like lots of fun. Tell me some things about it.
I did. It was super random. I had no idea what we will be doing until I got to the place. Yeah, and then I was just like, thank you. It was a cool costume, was it? I was like, all right, let's just go with the flow and enjoy this. So we had a really cool crew that took amazing care of us. The costumes were fun. The city that we went to, or the village, was very traditional, and me, I come from a traditional village actually in Moravia, so I'm used to these kind of, you know, village festivals and stuff. I always refused to take part because I was too shy, but now I had to. No, it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun.
So looking to the future a little bit, you mentioned a DJ last night when we were chatting. From the Netherlands, I think.
Yes.
What sort of direction is your music going to take after Eurovision?
I think I kind of found my style with Lie to Me, and of course I write many other tracks, but I would like to stick to this wave. I think it's something that makes me happy and makes the crowd go crazy, and it works. So yes, I would like to carry on this wave. My next single is in preparations, so that should be cool. We're also talking to some recording companies. Hopefully we'll close a deal soon, and it's going to be much bigger than before, so we'll see.
Talking about crowds, how was it performing in the Kyiv national final? It was a bit mad, right?
Man, it was insane.
You can say hi to Sergey. Remember Sergey?
Yes, Sergey, what's up? I'm very happy that you put all those takes that didn't work at the beginning. that was really fun. No, man, Ukraine was like completely different than I expected. All those people were just standing from half of the performance. They were just like standing. I said, stand up, Ukraine. Everybody was like, stood up and cheered so loud. It was a great vibe. And every time as an artist, if you get a response, it fills you with so much energy and love. So man, I would love to go back and do it again. So yeah.
So lots of stops on the promo tour. You're going to be excited about that. You're going to be a very busy chap for the next few weeks.
Oh yeah. So I'm trying to go to every pre-party pretty much. We'll see how it works, but I know that sometimes I will have to be flying overnight to manage to do it. And yes, it'll be a busy time. However, I think I need to do this because, as was said at the press conference, really like 70% of all of my performances were done on the street, and I need to get some practice. So I'm only welcoming this. It's great that Eurovision takes you to places you would probably never go to see, you know. So I'm enjoying this process, and hopefully it's going to end up well and not with me being sick for 2 months. So
No, don't get sick.
All right.
Listen, lovely to speak to you. Thanks very much for your time. Normally I ask people to sing, but you're a little sick today, so
no
I'm
problem.
Not gonna.
I'll be
I'm
singing right now if you want.
Do you want to sing a little bit of Lie to Me?
No problem. So which part do you like? Do you like the verse or the chorus?
Whatever you want to sing.
Alright. So come and lie to me. Lie to me, oh baby. Come a little closer. Lie to me. Lie to me, oh baby. Lean upon my shoulder. Lie to me. Get that on my body and love me like it was always meant to be. And now you love somebody new. I always knew. So come and give it to me. Bye.
Okay, thanks so much for that. I think he deserves a round of applause for that. Don't you?
It's all right.
Listen, thanks very much, and good luck with the performance tonight. And we will see you in London in less than 2 weeks.
Yeah. See you soon. Thank you so much for the interview, and see you later tonight. Yeah.
Thanks so much.